Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Good morning to everyone. I'm so glad you've logged on this morning to be a part of this broadcast. We'd like you to invite your friends to join us as we discuss about destined to reign as kings. That's right. Destined to reign as king. God have given us a unique destiny as his children to reign in life and to reign over life circumstances. Now, invite your friends to come join wherever you are. Those logging in, thanks for coming on. Some of you all the way from Pakistan and England and Japan. God bless you, Sheriff. Thanks for joining. But I would like you to just invite people, click on the share button and get your friends to join in this broadcast as we deal with this very exciting subject, destined to reign as kings. Let us pray. Father, we thank you, Lord. We give you praise. You are so faithful to us. Speak to us now by your spirit and let your word transform our lives. Lord, we thank you and we give you praise for all what you're about to do right now in the lives of your people. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. Yes, 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 9 said, you are a chosen generation. You've been chosen by God, a royal priesthood, and a holy nation, his own special people, that you may proclaim the praises of him who called you out of darkness into his marvelous light. So God has destined you to reign and to rule in life as a king. You know, not only does he want you to know you are royalty, he also expects you to live as one. And the circumstances in life might try to make you think contrary to that, but God does not just want you to know you are royalty, but he wants you to live as one, to know that you have been destined to rule, to reign, and to dominate as a king on this earth. I said the other time that Jesus Christ has all authority, and Jesus Christ has all power, all dominion given to him, and he lives in heaven. So his head, the head is in heaven, and the body is on earth, and the head and the body makes up the person of Jesus Christ. So you have dominion and authority to rule and to reign on this earth. That every circumstances, every situation in life, you can rule and reign over it and overcome all circumstances of life. So it tells us in 1 Peter 2 verse 9, you have been made royalty. You are not an ordinary being. You are a special made by God, specially made by God. You know, so you are not ordinary. It tells us in the book of Revelation chapter 1 verse 5 to verse 6, it's, and from Jesus Christ to the faithful witness, the firstborn from the dead, he said, and the ruler over the kings of the earth. See that? Jesus is the ruler over the kings of the earth. Jesus is the ruler over the kings of the earth. He said, and to him who loved us and washed us from our sins in his own blood, has made us kings and priests to his God and Father, to him be glory and dominion forever and ever. Amen. So Jesus, he said in this scripture, has made us kings, has made you king. He has made you king. That's right. He loved you, he washed through all of your sins, and has made you kings and priests to his God and to his Father. So it tells us that Jesus Christ, the Father, is the ruler over the kings of the earth. So when you wake up in the morning and you look at yourself in the mirror, it's important you tell the one on the other side you are royalty. When you wake up in the morning and look at yourself trying to get ready to get out, and you check yourself out, tell that person on the other side of the mirror that you are royalty, that you are king, or you are a queen. You got to look at yourself and begin to speak out who you really are. Don't allow what people whatever they put on you to be to be who you are. No, you are not the label men or women put on you. You are who God says you are. So when you begin to practice that, you begin to look at yourself and practice and tell yourself you are royalty. You have to practice walking, you have to practice talking and practice acting as a king or a queen, because that is who God sees when he looks at you. Whenever God looks at you, He doesn't see somebody who is less than that. Whenever God looks at you, he sees you as a king or as a queen. That is who you are. He is the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. He sees you as king. He sees you also as Lord. And that is important that you know. When God looks at you, he sees you as a queen. You know, remember, the Bible calls him, calls God, Jesus Christ, the King of Kings. So he is the mighty God. But we are kings under him. So don't hold a negative picture of yourself as one who is helpless or one who is needy. Don't hold that. Whenever that comes to your mind and make you have the sense of helplessness or the sense of neediness, you got to remove that picture from your mentality. You got to get it from that consciousness, because your consciousness becomes your reality. I'll say it again. Your consciousness of yourself becomes the reality of your experience. So what you are conscious about becomes what becomes real in your in real life. So you must begin to have the consciousness of who God says you are. God calls you a king, so you are. God calls you a queen, so you are. And whatever negative connotation put on you by men or women, you refuse to accept it in your consciousness, because when you accept who you are not as who you are, you gravitate towards that direction. But God wants you to see yourself as that king, as that queen, as that royalty, and begin to understand that and begin to walk in the light of that. And because you are God's royalty, you have been divinely delegated to exercise authority and dominion over the devil, over demonic forces of darkness. That's correct. Because you are royalty, because you are king, because you have been made the Lord on this earth, you have been deputized, you have been authorized, and you have been delegated to exercise that authority and that dominion over the devil, over demonic forces, over circumstances of life, over anything that tries to come on you, because you are royalty and because you are king. And the way the word functions, you must understand, this word governs by words. Well, this word is ruled by words. I'll say it again. The word is ruled by words. So you got to know how you open your mouth and speak what pertains to you, what God says you are, not what man says you are, not what somebody calls you, trying to make you, put you down and make you look like you are a nobody. No, you are a somebody in the eyes of God. You are royalty, you are a king, you are a queen. For the Bible tells us in the book of Ecclesiastes chapter 8 verse 4, is a where the word of a king is, there is power. And that is important, you notice. That's why I encourage you to always say what you mean and mean what you say, and say the right words from your mouth. Because where the word of a king is, there is power. Ecclesiastes chapter 8 verse 4. Where the word of a king is, there is power. So that means your words are backed with power to change any negative situation and put the devil to flight each time. Every time the devil raises up his ugly head against you, you put him to flight by the usage of your word. Because everything in this world is ruled by word. What men say dominate. So what you say dominate when you understand that you are a king, that you are royalty, that your words are backed with power and with authority to change every negative situation, circumstances in your life, and to put the devil, the enemy of your soul, to flight. Every time demonic spirits have to come against you, come against what you do, come against your agenda for living, you speak the word against it, and it flees. It takes off immediately. So kings talk boldly. Kings are not at the mercy of anyone. Kings, it is not in their nature to be apologetic. Kings, they talk with boldness. They talk with so much certainty. They know who they are. I've never seen a king begging his subject. No way. So you understand that the devil is under you. Circumstances of life, they are under you. So you speak from your mouth with that boldness and with the courage, because you know who you are and whose you are. You talk boldly. You know, you're not at the mercy of the enemy or at the mercy of life circumstances. Life will bring things in your way. No, whatever life brings your way, it should not grind you into dust. If life have a grinding effect, it grinds and it polishes you, and you come out better than you went in. Whatever's happened in your life today is not an indication that it's over with you. It's never over until God says so. It's never over until God says it's over. And as far as I know from the scripture, God never says over with you. So when life throws some lemons at you, understand, as a king, make lemonade from those lemons. When life begins to throw things and begins to grind and grind life around you, no, come out better than you went in. Don't come out bitter, you come out better. Because life has a way of doing that. But you can make up your mind as a king that whatever comes your way in this season, in this time of life, that you have made up your mind to act as a royalty, to believe you are royalty, to talk like royalty. You must understand that because you know you are royalty, your words carry power. You have to know that. You have to have the consciousness of your royalty in your psyche. You have to understand that. So when you issue a command to Satan or decree a thing in any negative situation in your life, you do it with so much authority, with so much boldness, because you know that when you make a decree, it is established, because you know who you are. When kings make decrees, it's established. Kings don't make decree and expect the subject to revolt. No, kings make decree, and whatever the decree is established. That's why it tells us in Job 22:28, you shall decree a thing and it shall be established. You decree it and it's established, because you are acting out of your royalty, out of being a king and being a queen. So you are not going to be acting like a wimp. No, it doesn't matter what comes against you in life. You know who you are, and God wants you to understand you are destined to reign as kings, to reign as kings and royalty. You have to have your living every day with this consciousness. See, living every day with this consciousness will impact positively on every aspect of your life. Of course, it will impact your prayer life. No more are you begging God in prayer. You pray like the righteous, with authority and with power. We discussed this yesterday, that you are the righteousness of God. God, by the virtue of what Jesus Christ has done on the cross, as you have been made righteous. And remember, we read yesterday, book of Romans, that you reign in life. It is those who have received the abundance of grace and the free gift of righteousness, they shall reign in life through Jesus Christ. So you receive the abundance of grace, and then you receive the free gift of righteousness. Righteousness means you have right standing with God, that God is not mad at you, that God is in love with you, that you and God, you have reconciled one to one another, and because of what Jesus Christ has done. So you act boldly and confidently, knowing you are backed up by God. We just read 1 Peter 2 verse 9. You are a chosen generation. You have been chosen by God to reign. You have been chosen by God to excel. You have been chosen by God to triumph. You have been chosen by God to remain on top only and never beneath. And it doesn't matter what tries to come in your direction. You just know that victory belongs to you. He said you are a royal priesthood. He said you are a holy nation, His own special people. It's nice to know you are special in the eyes of God. Men may say you are not special, but God says you are special. And you are to proclaim the praise of God, who have called you out of darkness into His marvelous light. You know, I love what it says in the book of, I believe, chapter 5 of Revelation, verse 9 and verse 10. So, and they sang a new song, saying, you are worthy to take the scroll and to open its seals, for you were slain and have redeemed us to God by your blood, out of every tribe and every tongue and people and nation, and have made us kings and priests unto our God, and we reign on earth. So now you have to believe what I've just shared with you, because life is a function of belief. If you can believe what you have just heard today and begin to walk in that consciousness, you begin to see the reality manifest in your living. Until you walk in the consciousness, you cannot experience the reality of it. It is a consciousness that gives birth to reality. What you are conscious of the most is what manifests in your life. So consciousness means you just believe what you've heard, and you think about it, and you dwell in the light of that, and you're going to see manifestation of what God says in your heart. What God says in your life, you got to believe it. Romans chapter 10, verse 8 to verse 10 talks about believe with your heart. You have to believe. Romans 4, verse 5 says, but to him who does not work but believe on him who justified the ungodly, his faith is accounted for righteousness. You got to just believe you are righteous based on your faith in what God has done for you. You have to believe you are righteous. You have to believe that you are in right standing with God. You know, you have to believe with all of your heart. You have to believe with all of your being. The Bible says that faith without work is dead. Of course, the emphasis here is believe. You know, that work is, the work is believe. You know, so how do I believe? How do you believe that you are royalty? How do you believe that you are to reign as king? How do you even believe that you are a king? How do you believe you are Lord? I mean, look at what it tells us here in 2 Corinthians 4 verse 13. And since we have the same spirit of faith, according to what is written, I believed and therefore I speak. We also believe and therefore speak. When you believe, you speak it. When you believe, you speak it from your heart. When you believe, you declare from your heart. You speak who God says you are. You speak from your mouth, you are royalty. You speak from your mouth that you are actually a king, and you declare it as God says it in his word. When you believe, you speak it. If you believe you are royalty, you speak it out. It doesn't matter what anybody says. It doesn't matter how you might feel currently. You just speak out who you are. You are royalty. That's correct. When you have that kind of mentality, it gives you a level of boldness to deal with life circumstances and life situation. And that you are not moved by what you see. You don't even consider what you see. Because you are not normal if you are moved by faith. When you move by faith, you step into the realm of the supernatural. So you are not moved by what you see. You are not moved by what you see. You are not moved by what you hear. You don't even look at what you see. In fact, the Bible tells us, this is very critical, you know, that you don't consider what you see. You don't consider. If what you see is not in line with what God says, you don't consider it. Because to rule as king and to reign as king, you have to focus your attention on the things that God says God has given to you already. And 2 Corinthians 4 verse 18 says, why we look not at the things which are seen, but at the things which are not yet seen. For the things which are seen are temporal. The things which are not yet seen are eternal. See, what you are looking at right now, whatever thing you can see is subject to change. Is subject to change. The circumstances that you are seeing now that is bothering your heart and your mind is subject to change. If you can see it, it can change. That's what it's saying right here. So don't allow your present situation to make you think it's your final destination. Your current situation is not your final destination. So as royalty and as king, you speak and declare words, knowing fully well that what you are faced with today is not the final bus stop, or it's not your final destination. God is taking you somewhere. If you can see with the eyes of your consciousness, you can experience the reality of it. So you have to focus your eyes on what you've not yet seen manifest in the physical realm. So that's why it tells us right here that we look at not what you see. We do not look at the things which are seen. You don't look at what you see. You don't look at what is obvious. You look at the things which are not yet seen. So you can bring what is in the unseen world into the seen world. So you have things that is added on the unseen world. The unseen world is just as real, more real than the seen world. So you look at the things which you not yet see in the unseen world, and you put them into your reality by your belief and by faith. That's what it says. And the Bible tells that even Abraham is a good example of that. Abraham was about 100 years old, and he has no child. And his wife was 90, and the wife has no child either, but God promised them to give them a baby. And the Bible gave us an example of Abraham, the way he focused on what is not yet seen to receive what is what not yet seen to manifest in his reality. Chapter 4 verse 19. He said, and Abraham not being weak in faith, he did not consider his own body already dead, since he was 100 years old, and deadness of Sarah's womb. So Abraham did not consider his body. He did not consider, but he was strong in faith and did not stagger at God's promise. So it comes to a time now that you don't consider the things you see. You don't consider what you're going through right now. You don't consider what men say about you right now. Because whatever thing you see that is not what you desire is subject to change. You believe with your heart against your senses. You believe with your heart against your senses. You believe with your heart against your senses. And I'll say it again. You believe with your heart against your senses. If your senses is telling you something different, you believe with your heart against what your senses tell you. Because faith is not in the arena of your senses. Faith is in the arena of the heart. Faith is a product of a recreated spirit. It's a product of the heart. So you believe with all of your heart what the word of God says, and you hold on to that word, and you will see the manifestation, and you declare word from your mouth as a king, as royalty, as a child of God. Because what you say means a lot as a royalty. Look at what it tells us in Romans 10 verse 9. What does it say? The word is near you, even in your mouth and in your heart. So the word is near you. The word is right in your mouth and in your heart. That is the word of faith which we preach. Verse 9. If you confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in your heart that God has raised him from the dead, you shall be saved. Isn't that so easy? You confess with your mouth. You believe in your heart that Jesus is alive and you are saved. If you are watching me today from different parts of the globe and you have not yet saved by Jesus Christ, you can just confess with your mouth that Jesus is Lord and believe in your heart that God has raised him from the dead, and you'll be saved. It's as simple as that. And if you do that, if you pray this prayer, if you ask God that you believe, that you confess with your mouth that Jesus, I confess that you are Lord, and I believe in my heart that you are alive, come and live in my heart, be my Lord and my Savior. If you pray this simple prayer, it means you are saved. You can inbox us. You can send us a message. We'll be willing to work with you on this and even help you as you grow in the things of God. But verse 10 says, for with the heart one believes unto righteousness, and with the mouth confession is made unto salvation. You see that? So with your heart, you believe unto righteousness. With right standing with God. With your heart, you believe you are right with God. With your mouth, you speak salvation. With your mouth, you confess unto salvation. So to get out of that thing you are in today, you have to speak with your mouth. It is what you come out of your mouth that brings you out into the place of salvation. Salvation from the devil. Salvation from lack. Salvation from disease. Salvation from sickness. Salvation from depression. Salvation from any vices of the enemy. You have to declare with your mouth. You have to believe you are royalty. You have to believe you are a king. You have to believe you are a queen. And as you declare with your mouth, you begin to see the move of God manifesting in your life. You are not afraid to believe God. You believe him because your consciousness translates into reality. When you believe what God says and you declare with your mouth, you begin to experience the move of God in your life. You begin to see that what you believe and what you are conscious about and what you confess becomes your reality in life. Then I want to stop here today. But just remember this. You have been destined to reign as kings. And you are to walk in it. You are to walk in that reality. You are to talk like it. You are to live like it. You are to think like it. And don't allow any circumstances or anything contrary to this to put you down. You are royalty. You are a king. You are a queen. Talk like it, walk like it, live like it. Let that consciousness remain in you consistently, and you will see how your life turn around and become exactly who God have called you to be. Man, I'm glad you've logged on. But there are three things I would like to say you can do for us. Number one, you can share this video right now. Share it. Just click on the share button, and that would be wonderful. Share this video and let your friends be a part of this. Let them know what is happening. And thanks for those that have been sharing it. I appreciate you because this has been going all over the world. Thousands of people have been viewing this broadcast every single day. So please keep on sharing it. It's very helpful. It helps to spread the word. Number two, you can pray for the ministry. There's power in prayer when you pray in faith. Pray for us. Keep on praying for the increase that we're experiencing to continue to increase. And God keep on doing an amazing things in the ministry through your prayer. And number three, you can give. You can support us financially. There's a link on your screen, PayPal, Cash App, and Zelle. Write the check, whatever it is. But whatever God places in your heart, you can support us to keep what we are doing going and reaching all to the part of the world. Those of you that have been supporting us financially, we appreciate you. Thank you so much for those of you that have been giving through PayPal, through Cash App. We really appreciate you all. Keep on supporting. And I believe as you support, the same grace upon this ministry will also be released into your life, and your life never remains the same again. God begins to move in your life in a mighty way, and you will see that the benefit you are getting in this ministry will also be translated to you, because you're actually a part of the ministry and your seed is in the ground in this ministry. Man, I'm out of time for today's broadcast, but listen, until we see you again tomorrow, remember this: you have been destined to win, and there is nothing the devil can do about it. Keep on looking up. If life knocks you down, make sure you land on your back, because if you can look up, you can get up. Never over until you win. So don't you quit. You have been destined to reign as a king. And as kings, keep looking up. You will reign. Keep reigning through abundance of grace and the gift of righteousness. Until we see you tomorrow, remain blessed in the Lord. And also remember, tonight is Bible studies. If you live in the area, come out and be a part of a Bible study tonight at 7 p.m. Come and be a part of the Bible study. I'll be teaching to you. It'll be an amazing message coming out tonight. You come out, be blessed. Invite your friends to join us tonight at 7 p.m. The address is on your screen as well, 1020 Evansville, Bethlehem. If you're not in the area, log on at 7 and also be blessed by the teaching. Until we see, God bless you. In Jesus' name, amen.